Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. She's the bubbly, beautiful, and immensely talented actress and vocalist who graced small and big screens with favorites like Being Mary Jane, Just Right, and Sparkle.
Now, she's continuing her rise in Hollywood and BET's hit drama, The Family Business, and in OWN's new drama, Yes Baby, Ambitions. Take a look.
Is this Amara, the federal prosecutor speaking?
Could be Amara, your ex-best friend. Don't underestimate me, Stephanie.
Your sister needs to be handled.
You think you can just steal my restaurant? We are not for sale!
Either you convince her to sell, or I'm gonna have to step in.
Over my dead body.
I wouldn't have it any other way.
Please welcome Brely.
Walk and walk.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Get dressed for y'all.
Yes.
You look
so beautiful.
Serving at 9 in the morning.
Yes.
I love it, Brely.
Yes.
Have a seat, superstar.
Thank you so much.
Yes. So somebody told me you just won an NAACP award.
My Lord God, and I couldn't be there because I was here promoting, you know, getting ready for the show and everything.
Yes.
I am so grateful. NAACP award-winning actress.
Come on.
Where they do that at?
Right here.
Right here.
Yes. Look at that smile. Just well deserved. Just immensely talented.
Yes.
You know, a lot of people know that you are one, you're an actress and also a singer.
Yes.
Talk to us about the versatility in Hollywood and how that set you apart.
You know, I think that it's so grand to be able to use both of your gifts within one.
Yeah.
I thought that being a singer at first, that's all I could do. Mm-hmm. But then when I started acting, I was like, well, hold on, I can hum a note. I can just sing a line.
Yes.
And so I would do that from time to time, and it's granted me more opportunity in the music business. So
yes.
I'm like, okay, let's go.
Come on, look how God set it up.
I'm sitting here with a Brex. So I'm not going to
even sitting here with Ms. Evans, so hello.
Yes.
Come on now,
come on.
In and of itself. So let's talk about the Ambition soundtrack. I mean, but so far, it's so addictive. And I'm telling you, I said I don't have time for more than the shows, and I'm addicted to this one already.
Yes,
and
so
it's
good.
Just shameful. So I'm going to be glued to the television for the next 18 episodes. but what do you think is the impact of Black music on-screen shows?
It is so imperative because it becomes the soundtrack to our lives.
Yes.
You know, you'll hear the New Edition song again and go, that was on Ambitions. That's
yes.
Jamie Gidden's favorite
yes.
song.
Yes.
What's so amazing is that I love that we've got Will Packer to spend some money in that area because you know those songs cost.
Yes, I do.
So that production value just went sky high when we're like, please, can I have this song? So I'm just grateful that we got to do that. And again, it's just imperative to have our music playing through the backgrounds of our lives because it's going to take us back to a memory.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Speaking of playing through in that thread, the common thread that you have with all of your characters is that spunk, that pizzazz.
Yes.
What is it that you bring from yourself or who you are as Brely to each and every one of your characters?
You know, I always step Brely into their lives.
Okay.
And then I do remove a bit of myself because I want to experience all that they encompass.
Mm-hmm.
So that underneath, I guess Brely would be the foundation and then I kind of build the character from there. So that's that common theme you see.
Yes.
But oh honey, Rondell Lancaster,
yes.
You get to see that Oakland Brely. You get to see that Oaktown girl come out.
Yeah. So it's like a real piece of you when you play this character.
When I tell you, when I read this part, I immediately connected with it. When I sat with Benny Boom and Sheila Duxworth about getting the role, I said, okay, let me look up. Oh, I know her.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm from Oakland. Like, there's a lot of gentrification happening where I'm from, and I know my family members have been asked to move out and here go a check, and that's what grandmama and them gave us this house. What do you mean?
Yeah.
So it became real for me, and I began to fight for them within this character.
Yes. Tell us how this show, Ambitions, which is so delicious already from the premiere last night, how is it going to set itself apart from other shows?
It's going to set itself apart because I just keep coming up with this word, salacious.
Yes.
I was like, look that word up for me. I need to know what that means. Because that's what it's giving me. It's something, it's sexy, it's fast, it's funny. There are times when the one-liners, our writing team is off the chain.
That's why you're like, cheap soup.
Yes, that's what it is.
Absolutely. Of course, we love having Brely here. And if you're staying with us for the entire hour, Brely's coming over to the table. But make sure you continue to support Ambitions on OWN Tuesday nights at 10 p.m.
Of course, the conversation always continues at Sister Circle TV on all social media platforms.
Let's dance.
Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. We are back with the bold and beautiful Brely Evans. Yes. And Quad decided to join in on the fun. And with that said, I'm going to hand things over to Miss Quad.
Yeah.
Miss D.
I said, honey, I said if I was at work, I had to have a conversation.
You know what I mean? Let's talk about it.
But yes. You are doing your thing. I mean, we just talked about you when you came the first time. We were like, you have to come back when you get another movie, another series. And now you're into it at the same time.
Right. So, how does that happen? I mean,
well, Future made the song for you at the same
time.
Thank you, Future.
We like to thank you, babe.
Exactly. So ambitions and the family business. And while both families are very paralyzing, they got issues, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
There are some endearing moments we see within the thread of both of these families. Why do you think it's so important that we show those images on television and that it's represented properly?
You know, Quad, I think that it's time for us to tell our own narratives. Mm-hmm. And what the best part about it is the two projects you just named have African Americans telling the story.
Yes.
So we can control what is said, what is done, and how big or how small, and how real for us actors, how we get to be. Mm-hmm. So that is the best part of both of those projects.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
It's challenging to have someone else tell a very personal story that they're really not connected to.
That's been Hollywood for so long.
And then there's that.
And they're changing that. Speaking of Hollywood, we had a media mogul, Phil Thornton, on yesterday talking about how, you know, black women are pitted against each other in scripted and unscripted. Mm-hmm. Let's talk a little bit about, you know, that happening or not happening in your life in Hollywood, and how do you maintain those real friendships and making sure there's no cattiness amongst you?
That's good.
If I've ever encountered such a thing, I'm the one who paralyzes it and says, honey, we are not in competition.
Yes.
I cannot be you if I tried, and Lord knows you can't be me.
Nice.
It's just the truth. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? God has given us all these fingerprints for a reason, because he wanted us to know how he took his time to create and unique each one of us, right?
Yes.
So I always want to remind my sisters and be that, you know, that strong voice to say, honey, I applaud you, because you the bomb, you got it going on, and you fine as all get out. You know what I'm saying? I'm here to compliment what God has given you, and do me the same. You know what I'm saying?
How do we give to the people?
Yes, y'all do every time. Every time. So what I think about.
Yeah, that's good.
Well, even with that being said, you coach a series, and it's called Get Your Act Together.
Get it together and start living your dreams.
That's right.
Yes, let's talk about that message that you have.
It's my water walker message to everyone that says, I'm aspiring. I said, stop aspiring and do. Yeah. We have to be doers. And, you know, we have to get out there and get things done and start being the human beings that we were born to be.
Yeah.
So it starts, I want to aspire to be. No, I am an actor.
Yeah.
You know, people a lot of times come to me, or I want to quit my job. I say, honey, let's make your job your first investor of that business you really want to have. So God has given me this, I call it strange, Lord, but this strange ability to help people craft their way out of the boat. So the boat of procrastination, the boat of fear, the boat of, you know, debt, the boat of all. So I can help you strategize your way into walking on water and living your dream.
Yeah,
that's what that whole series is about.
You don't just talk about it, you walk that walk. On the last day, which was the last day we wrapped, you had a note for every person in the cast, the crew, but you went and you walked to every person. Can you talk to us about the value of making people feel important no matter what level they're on?
I just think you're so amazing for bringing that moment up. I felt some kind of way because I wanted to get everybody really big wrap gifts. And I had, my money, I'm climbing. But it was important to me to touch every camera person, every light grip, every makeup artist, every person that doesn't get to be in front of the camera. It was just important to me. So I said, what can I do? I said, I can buy everybody a lotto ticket. Baby, I'm selling dreams. I did. I said, I know how many people are on our set. I'm going to go buy these lotto tickets. I'm going to put them in envelopes. And then I'm going to go up to them and make all of you, make all of you pick your poison or whatever. But it was just important for me to touch every single person and not just get just my cast and just my, the big wigs, just Will of gift. It was important to touch them all to say, look here, we all have a dream.
That's right.
And our dreams connected together is what what creates this combustible thing that goes out to the world that helps them dream again too.
Yes.
So I just wanted to, like, you know, that pass out some
gesture.
Possibilities.
Yes, that little gesture made me cry. You just never know what that little gesture may have done for a PA who will be a showrunner one day. And then they will do that along the way.
Along the way.
So with that being said, are you going to be behind the camera producing, directing?
Can I just tell you, I got to give it up to one of my coaches, Mr. Troy Rollin. He told me, Brely, you're a director.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And so he was just in Atlanta a couple weeks ago, and I helped him teach acting class. And then he said, Brely, why don't you direct about 7 of them? I said, huh? And so he's pushing me in that way. And he's like, you have it. You have it. Trust it. And I didn't realize every time I've been on every set, I was in class.
Yes.
I've been in directing school.
Yes.
And so I found myself actually doing it. So yes, I shall be producing and directing very soon to tell our story our way.
Uh-huh.
So get ready, get ready, and get ready.
Oh, I'm ready.
Y'all ready?
I'm ready.
I know you're ready.
I'm trying to get ready.
No, you're ready.
You're ready. Stop aspiring. Stop aspiring. Come on, girl.
You're right. So I'm calling on all of you. So when you get that call for that LOI, you know what that is.
Yeah,
come on.
I absolutely love it. So what type of content would you like to create?
Do you know, I have a few. I have, I have 15 written projects that have been registered with the WGA.
Yes,
and I've been sitting on them, and now that my team is coming together, it is really making sense.
Mm-hmm.
So I have everything from scripted to scripted drama to that feel-good reality. You know that, what's the show I love so much? Undercover Boss, that stuff that make you cry.
Oh, yeah.
I have a few of those. I have, so it's kind of an array.
Yes, that's
of
good.
Things. It's going to be so
look,
exciting.
It could be 15 out of 15 or that one that make
it. It could be that one.
I got to ask you real quick before we leave.
Pay some college tuitions off.
Hello?
Pay some college, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Some fun.
All right.
Next.
Okay.
I'm going to claim that.
Well, tell us your dream role.
My dream role is to play in a movie with Meryl Streep. I just absolutely would love to be a superhero. Mm. I would love to be in a movie with Melissa McCarthy.
I think
our comedic timing.
That'd be so fun.
Oh my God, I think
that
it's time.
That would be so fun.
Melissa, you watching?
Let's put it in the universe. So
put it in the universe. I'm going to watch right now.
Right?
Yes.
I want to watch right now.
Hey. I want to watch right now.
Hey. Every Tuesday night at 10 p.m. Eastern on OWN Again.